Welcome students. Today we will study a poetry from 9th class English book, BEEHIVE. The Road Not Taken, written by Robert Frost. Students, before we start the poem, let's discuss a few important facts about the poet. Robert Lee Frost, an American poet and a playwright born on March 26, 1874, in San Francisco, California. A Road Not Taken is one of the popular poems written by Frost. He won Pulitzer Prize 4 times for his poetry. He won Congressional Gold Medal for his poetic works in 1960. Frost was nominated for the Nobel Prize in Literature 31 times. He wrote his first poem, My Butterfly. Stopping by woods on a snowy evening, fire and ice, mending walls, nothing gold can stay, dust of snow, the death of the hired man, acquainted with the night and botches are popular poems written by Frost. On July 22, 1961, Frost was named Poet Laureate of Vermont. He died of complications from prostate surgery in Boston on January 29, 1963. Students, now let's enjoy the poem. Road Not Taken. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both. And be one traveler long I stood, and looked down one as far as I could, to where it bent in the undergrowth. Then took the other just as fair, and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear, though as far that the passing there had fallen them really about the same. And both that morning equally lay in leaves, no steps had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for other day, yet knowing how we leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. I shall be telling this with a sigh somewhere ages and ages hence. The roads diverged in a yellow wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the differences. So students, now let's start the detailed explanation of the poem. The poet used here extended metaphor as two roads. Here means two choices of life. Students, metaphor is a figure of speech that describes a person or an object by referring to something that is considered to have similar characteristics to that person or object. In short, comparing two things. In the poem, the poet compared a diverged road with two life choices. Let's start the explanation of the poem. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both. In the first two lines, the poet says, while traveling a road in a yellow wood, suddenly the poet reached at a diversion point. The poet stood on the point from where the road was diverging into two different directions. He felt sorry for himself because he could not travel both the roads at the same time. So key points here we need to know. Here two roads means two ways of life. And yellow wood symbolizes the autumnal wood, means season of autumn. The poet found himself in a complete state of dilemma, where he was not able to decide that which road he should travel on. Important words here, diverged means forked or divided in two different directions, and yellow wood, autumnal wood, means that state of wood in the season of autumn when leaves from the trees had fallen on the ground. And be one traveler long I stood and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. It was not possible to travel on both the roads. Writer stood for a long time looking at the road as far as he could. He was trying to choose the best option. He could see the diverged road up to a long distance where it disappeared in a dense growth of plant and bushes. Students, the poet was standing in complete state of confusion and he was not able to decide that which road he should take. He points here in third and fourth and fifth line. Line 2, 3 and 4 are examples of anaphora. Anaphora means repetition of words or phrase at the beginning of successive line. As you can see, and. And is repeated in all three lines, line 2, 3 and 4. These lines show that the life we have such situation many times where we have to take tough decisions. We ponder deeply before taking a decision. Important words here in these lines, undergrowth. Undergrowth means dense growth of plants and bushes. Explanation for lines 6, 7 and 8. Then took the other just as fair and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear. But says after thinking for a long time, he decided to take the second road, because it looked more suitable. He took the path covered with grass as it symbolized that this road was traveled by very less people. Here, wanted wear means the road needed to be traveled. Key points in these lines, wanted wear is an example of personification. Dear students, personification means when we give human qualities to some non-human thing. Alliteration, wanted wear. Repeating sound of W. The poet gives here a message that we should try to take some difficult walks. As in the given lines, he decided to travel the road which was traveled by less people. So important words here, fair. Fair means good. And claim. Claim means better option and grassy means unused. Let's take explanation for line 9, 8 and 10. Though as far that the passing there had warned them really about the same. After walking a small distance, the poet found that both the roads are equally traveled. Sometimes we think that the option chosen by us is the best, but soon we realize that the option we took is already tried by many others as well. So, in the given lines, the important points we need to know is, this is an example of antithesis. Both the lines mentioned here, 9 and 10, is the example of antithesis. Firstly, the poet says that the road he took is traveled by less people, but after some time, as he traveled some distance, he says both the roads were equally traveled. Students, antithesis is a poetical device in which two opposite ideas are put together. As you can see here, firstly he says he wanted to travel the road which was traveled by less people, and at the same time after traveling for some distance he says that the road was traveled by same as the other road was traveled by many people. So important words here, had warned them really about the same shows both the roads walked similarly by the people. Explanation to line 11 and 12. And both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden like. The poet says that that morning both the roads were covered with yellow leaves, and those leaves were not walked over by someone. Leaves were not trodden or crushed. That morning he was the first person to walk on the road. As soon the poet reached on the diversion point of the road, looking at the leaves, that had fallen on the road. The boy thought that nobody had traveled before him. So, after walking for some distance, he came to know that both the roads were equally traveled by so many people. Key point here, we need to know the above two lines are examples of imagery. Students, imagery means when poet, with the help of using such words and creating visual representation of ideas in our mind. And important words here we need to know is trodden. Trodden means walked over or crushed underneath something. The word is used here for leaves. Another lines, oh, I kept the first for another day, yet knowing how we lead on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. In these lines, poet says that finally he decided to take the less traveled road and he kept the first one for some other day, although he was not sure of his coming back. Here, the poet says sometimes in life we take decisions for doing something, thinking that if we fail in that particular work, we shall try another option later on. But it's not sure that whether we'll get that option of making a choice once again or not. Key points here, line 13 and 15 is an example of antithesis. As in line 13, he says, I kept the first for another day, but in line 15, he says, I doubted if I shall ever come back. Students, we have already discussed the point antithesis, like when two different ideas are put together at the same time. As earlier, poet says that I kept first road for the other day, but at the same time, he says that I doubted whether I will come back to take that time or not. So this is called antithesis. Two opposite ideas put together. I shall be telling this with a sigh somewhere ages and ages hence, two roads diverged in wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the differences. Use of the word sigh probably shows here that the poet feels sorry for his decision on traveling that road, and he was disappointed. So he says in future he will tell someone that how in his life once he reached at such difficult situation when he had to take a tough decision. The word sigh shows here that somehow the poet was not happy about his decision that he had taken long time back. Vocabulary here, sigh means a deep breath. When you take a deep breath telling something to someone else with a feel of disappointment. Ages and ages means showing a period of very long time. Two roads diverged in a wood and I took one less traveled by and that has made all the differences. Here the poet says that the decision he took long ago changed his life, made all the differences in his life. He says his present life situation is the result of the choice he made long ago when he was a young man. He gives a very strong message to one and all that we must be very careful while taking a decision because the choice you make today will decide your future. So important point here is ages and ages. This is an example of alliteration. Students, alliteration is a poetical device where it means the occurrence of the same letter or sound at the beginning of closely connected words. As you can see, ages and ages. A, sound of A is repeating in both the words. And same can be taken as an example of repetition, ages and ages, because the word is repeated twice in a single line. So in short, if we talk about essence of the poetry, the poem as an extended metaphor represents human life. Undoubtedly, there comes a moment in everyone's life when he or she needs to take a decision wisely and intellectually. Because your today's choice will determine your future. In future, whether you will narrate your moment of taking that decision with a deep sigh and disappointment like the poet or with a feeling of happiness and excitement will depend on your today's choice. In short, the poet says that one needs to be very, very careful while taking a choice for life. So, dear students, I hope this video will help you to understand this beautiful poem. And don't forget to subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get more videos for your English chapter. Thanks and good luck.